Today, we're talking about continually,神农本草经。We say we use three class. We discuss for 神农本草经。So today is the last class. And next week is a reading break. But after reading break, is our midterm. So we finish 神农本草经 first. Then we do some review. Prepare for our midterm. So that's for today. So 神农本草经 we say it separate with three category herbs. Super category, middle category, inferior category. So they separate these three categories mainly by its functions. Like a super category mainly for tonify, and the middle category for the treatment. E for category, still for the treatment. Super category mainly is green herb. Middle category mainly is Chen herb. And the inferior category mainly is Duo Shi herb. So that's firstly, they separate by their function. And then they have subcategory, separated by what kind of material and what source of the herbs. So we finish, super category. Certainly, we just pick up some herbs. We are not like talking about 120 herbs. We pick up some pretty commonly used herbs. We finish super category. So today we still pick up some typically herbs in the middle category and the inferior category. We discuss like what they mention in 神农本草经. So that's the first half of class. We finish 神农本草经，then we do some review, and we talking about our midterm. Midterm will be happens right after our reading break next week. Then we go to middle category first. Super category we finished already last week. So middle category herbs. We say herbs in middle category still 120 herbs there. Some herbs may have toxin. Some herbs may don't have toxin. So that's we mainly use for treatment. But some herbs, if they have toxin, maybe we still not use so long time. So that's in this category, they use for Chen herb. The first herb we go to Ganjiang. So commonly used herbs. Ganjiang Chule is warming herb and pungent herb. So that's basically we treat some cold condition for sure because it's warming. and especially internal warming. We say 干姜生姜. 生姜 more go to superficial. 干姜 more go to deeper. Like we treat superficial problem formula usually we use 生姜. Like 桂枝汤, that's treat superficial problems. 小青龙汤, that's usually still treat internal flame, external cold condition. 干姜 we mainly treat internally. Internally, like we put for 四逆汤, warming internally. So that's basically 干姜 and 生姜. They both warming. So we talking about mainly treat chest problems. And the qi go to wrong direction. That's still, when we talking about the qi go to wrong direction, similar like we talking about qi reverse. Yeah, reverse. Reverse the qi clinically cause two mainly symptoms. If long qi reverse, it causes cough. Another situation, stomach qi reverse may be cause nausea, may be cause vomiting. So that's truly, 干姜 can go to upper jiao and the middle jiao warming. Then they can treat like a reverse qi kind of conditions. So that's mainly warming the middle jiao, but truly it go to upper jiao also. And also stop bleeding. So in here, we didn't talk about especially ER herbs, they have what they call pao jia. So pao jia is a charred. 干姜, yeah, charred 干姜. We know herbs charred. Mostly, they will have function to stop bleeding. And also, it warming. So, 泡姜 in some formula, specially treat gynecology problems, gynecology bleeding kind of problems, warming the uterus and stop bleeding. And promoting sweating. So certainly it's warming. It has promoted sweating function. But I would like to say promote sweating. 生姜 working better. And the treat with the B, with damp B syndrome. Wind dam B cause the pain. Thus, we can use 干姜. Still warming make like qi circulation, make like fluid circulation, and relieve wind dam B condition. And also can treat intestinal diarrhea. This kind of diarrhea basically, still caused by cold inside. And dysentery. Dysentery is kind of a special kind of diarrhea, like some mucus inside. But dysentery sometimes may easily caused by damp heat condition, not truly damp cold condition. So we need to make our diagnosis to see if it caused by cold, we can use ganjiang. But if it caused by heat, ganjiang is too warm. Or maybe you can put some other herbs to balance, like some cold herb go to yin, then to balance the formula. And uncooked means not prepared, especially get a good result. So that's basically like we're talking about the shengjiang function. Ganjiang is kind of prepared shengjiang. So we're talking about the shengjiang more go to superficial. Ganjiang more go to deeper. So that's we're talking about the shengjiang here. And if take for a little bit longer time, can relieve some bad smell. So this kind of bad smell, I believe people have like a diarrhea or dysentery, then patient have pretty bad smell. Now we treat diarrhea kind of condition and stop it, then the bad smell is disappeared. So it's not like a patient has some body smell, then we specially use it, then stop it. And
So one question. I thought if the diarrhea was really badly smelling that it indicated heat, then you wouldn't use this herb.
Yeah, that's true. That's what we're talking about. You may use ganjiang with some like three yellow herbs together to balance it. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Sometimes patients have complicated condition, like upper heat, lower cold condition. So sometimes, like they may have like intestine, some damp heat there, but stomach, some cold there. So that kind of condition, we need to balance the formula and get it released.
Thank you.
Yeah, you are welcome. So that's for this one. And the next sentence is pretty interesting here. Are able one to communicate with spirit? Yeah, communicate with the Shen. So not truly explanations for this sentence, like how Ganjiang communicated with the Shen. I think that's still kind of a cold condition, like a patient losing some Shen and we warming there and got a pretty good communicated with Shen. But it looks like right now we didn't talk about specially like a ganjiang with the Shen disorders. Then talking about where they go. Girls in the river and the valleys. So that's for ganjiang. Ganjiang right now we use a lot of formulas. Mainly is internally warming, yeah, internal warming. Mainly we're talking about it warming upper jaw and the middle jaw, but truly some condition like a lower jaw colony, like we're talking about some gynecology problem. We are more used for pouch, charred ganjiang, more warming and also can stop bleeding. Gynecology problems, mostly relationship with bleeding problem. So basically, we have three different kind of, we call them. First two, we are pretty familiar. Shengjiang, Ganjiang. Shengjiang is a rushed herb. Ganjiang is kind of prepared. And then we have another form, is Paojiang. Paojiang is a char. Paojiang is char. So that's about Ganjiang. So Ganjiang, generally speaking, still pretty safe to use. But truly, it depends. We couldn't use too big amount. So that's put in the middle category. And also because it warm nitrates. We say if they have specially cold nitrates or warm nitrates, they will balance the body's cold or heat condition. That's especially used for the treatment. So that's the first herb in middle category we're talking about this idea. Then we're talking about another herb, Dangui. So Dangui is still, it's kind of right now in a tonified category. Mainly blood tonified. But they also have moving blood function. It's a tonified blood. And the moving block. So Dangui is the root. It looks like this kind of shape, the root. So basically, Dangui, this big size, we call the height of Dangui. And the middle side, we call the body of the Dangui. And the ending side of the tail of the Dangui. So tonified blood, body part and the head part is better. If we try to move in blood, the tail part is better. You can think about the fish. Fish swimming in the water. The tail part is more mutable, but the head part is not mutable. So basically more moving there, similar like the fish in the water is more moving for the tail part. That's more moving blood. When you order the whole herbs, if they call the Quan Dangui, Quan is whole, yeah, whole. The whole is whole like a root in there, including the head part, body part, and the tail part. Then they cut a piece to piece. So you can see the shape like this. Sometimes you can specially order the tail of Dangui. They call Dangui Wei. Wei is tail part. Yeah, wait, this tail part. If you order specially head of Dangui, they call Dangui Tou. Tou is head. the body part is dangui shen o ti. So when you order dangui, to see what function you like, keep dangui. But truly, sometimes you can order quan dangui. You have both tonified blood and moving blood function. But if you specially need the moving blood, order dangui wei. And if some people got a pregnancy, and the same time have blood deficiency, but we don't try to move blood too much for pregnancy. In that kind of case, you can order either dangui tou or dangui shen without dangui wei. So that's mainly we keep tonified functions, but less mean. So that's for dangui. So dangui for five flavors that belong to sweet. Bouqi is warm, but it's not that warm like ganjiang, but still belong to warm and no toxins. So right now we use dangui mainly for blood tonify. But in Shenlong Bencao Jing, we're talking about mainly treat cough and qi, control flow qi. So that's a little bit different actions compared right now we use dangui. So they say dangui mainly go to the liver. Yeah, go to the liver. We know like a liver have easy. We run two herbs they use. Why is taihu? Why is dangui? And also they can nourish internally. So in Shenlong Bencao Jing, they also talking about warm malaria with fever. So that's they talking about the patient health conditions like a fever and a chilled condition. So that kind of condition, we can think about use dangui to treat it. Especially they talking about on the skin levels. So that's something that will be different. Right now we're talking about, look like we are now truly talking about use dangui treat malaria. Malaria kind of condition for TTM is kind of Shaoyang condition. Like a fever, chilled, adelaide. So if we're thinking about a dangui go to the liver and the liver gallbladder, is kind of a zangfu relationship in there. So that's maybe the idea treat malaria. And linking cause infertility. So that's talking about bleeding situation in here in a female. So that's they say bleeding and cause blood deficiency and then cause the infertility. So that's especially dangui more nourishing there and treat that kind of conditions. And also can treat different kind of species like injured, the wood in there. So that kind of situation, we still can thinking about it's more blood nourishing and more blood circulation go to the skin and then help the skin healing. So then we talking about cooking it. Yeah, cooking it, use it, cooking it. Mainly, dangui go to decoction. Dangui also is pretty good herbs for food therapy. Like some people have some blood deficiency kind of condition, you can put dangui to the soup and cook it. But the dangui smell pretty strong, if you go to the soup, maybe not too big amount, otherwise dangui smell pretty strong. So that, but generally say cooking dangui does get better result. So that's for dangui. And grossing in the river and the body. So that's the second herb we're talking about in this category. So something we still use the actions, something look like a little bit different with right now we use it. Then we go to another herb we call Danshen. Don't confuse it with Danshen. Yeah. So this is without D. Yeah, without D, Danshen. They have different functions. So Danshen is bitter. Slightly cold, not that too cold. It's no toxins. So Danshen is still pretty good herbs. Right now, we're talking about we can nourishing blood and moving blood. That's Danshen. In TCM, we have some idea. One Danshen equaled 4 wu. Si wu means 4 wu tang. Si wu tang functions mainly tonify blood. And the moving blood. Shu di, dangui, bai xiao, cun xiong. So basically, cun xiong inside have function moving blood. And also dangui, we just talking about dangui wei, yeah, tail part of dangui also have function moving blood. But dangui itself have two functions, tonify blood and moving blood. So that's some people say one dangui required. So that's one Danshen required. So Danshen is a pretty good herb. And also modern study for Danshen. but Dianxian pretty good herbs to prevent like a blood stasis situation inside the tulip, like blood circulation. So right now we have Dianxian injections and Dianxian pill used in China, very popular right now, to prevent and treat patient have like a heart attacking kind of condition. So heart attacking kind of condition mainly belong to blood stasis. So it's very, very good herbs right now people use it. So in Shennong Ben Chao Ding, yeah, Shennong Ben Chao Ding, talking about it's mainly treat like evil qi in the heart and abdominal area. So evil qi here, they didn't specially talking about what kind of evil qi. But truly, right now we're still thinking about if patient have heart attacking kind of condition, that still belong to evil qi in the heart. And also including middle diaphragm, abdominal area. And also treat the condition like some sounds or qi passing the water kind of sounds, like water moving in the intestine. So that kind of condition, we can think about like in the intestine, kind of a stagnation and cause some blocking there. Then some qi moving internally. So that can cause like by qi stagnations and the qi not moving, maybe caused by cold, maybe caused by heat. So that's basically we say can treat either cold or heat conditions. And also treat conditions, especially mainly in the abdominal area. That's the meaning, 增加. So like abdominomyosis, we talk about we have two conditions. Zheng is like a blood stasis condition. Jia is a qi stagnation kind of condition. So truly, Dianxian we talk about, they have moving function. Moving qi, moving blood. So that's broken zheng and jia. Relieve stagnations and relieve some qi stagnation or maybe blood stasis caused failures in local eye. So that's mainly for Dianxian, talking about functions. So grossing, the Dianxian grossing in mountain and valley. So deep in the herbs, the grossing way gave it some nitriles. And when we use treat the condition, also take it nitrile, like a cold or heat condition. So that's for Dianxian, that's for Dianxian. So Dianxian right now, we are very, very popular use. Another herb in this category, I pick up Lu Rong. 鹿茸 right now in our herb category, 羊 totally fine. So, 鹿茸, we know it's coming from the deer. So that's sweet and warm. We talked about the herb nitro before. We say eat the herb coming from the animals. Generally say they have better result, treatment result. Right now we still use Lulong. I think we still can use Lulong because Lulong, like if you cut it, they still grow up. Yeah, it's not truly killed animals. So mainly treat like the situations, still we talk about linking of the blood, like gynecology problems. So we say it is pretty good young 25 herbs. So linking of the blood, lot of condition, maybe king yang difference. So that's we can use to treat. But truly, yeah, truly, Lulong is not too hard for us. We can treat like a generally cold and heat condition. So that's generally say more stronger tonic king. And then we call like a regular lower jaw. And also 25T. And when qi is strong, patient body of strong. And we're talking about especially 25 qi yang. Kidney control the bone. T like the terminal part of the bone. So that's promoting growth of the teeth and preventing people getting aging. Pretty similar like we talked about the super category growth. Super category, we talked about the no toxin. We can use a pretty longer time and preventing aging. So that's Lulong pretty similar. Like super category herb, but truly, Lulong no toxin also. So the herb, that's basically directly coming from the deer part, also can use treat source. And upset, like some skin issue and swollen, relieve the passengers. So that's talking about keep the blood in the internal body, yeah, genitals here means in the in level. Like the meaning, holding blood inside, don't like the blood go to outside. Still kind of meaning is codified. So there's some translation that'll be difficult to understand. It's not only translation. Like I say, Shen Nong Ben Cao Jing is coming from like 2000 years ago. They try to use pretty short words. But the Chinese characters, one character, they have a lot of meaning. So pretty confusing. Yeah, pretty confusing. But here, Jasmine keep the blood in the in levels. So that's generally say, 鹿茸 is good herb, can go to 葱麻丁. We know 葱麻丁 is more close relationship with the female. And the female truly need more blood. So 鹿茸 itself is pretty nourishing or tonified, 葱 and tonified blood, nourishing blood. And also they go to kidney and tonified kidney. So 鹿茸 is pretty good herb. But truly 鹿茸 right now is very expensive. So that's we look like we are not that commonly used, but 鹿茸 truly is good herb. So that's the middle category. We just pick up four herbs. We discuss, we get some basic idea what middle category herbs is look like. Yeah, to see if we have questions. Then we go to infra category. We say infra category herbs mostly maybe have some toxin. And the infra category herbs mainly used for treatment. And usually we are not long-term used. In the formula we use for 左使鹤, that's originally in 神农本草经. But truly later on, when we have formula, we still some herbs we use like a 君鹤 or 臣鹤. The first herb we go to 附子. So, 附子 is pungent herb and warm and toxic. Yeah, originally they talk about big toxins. So, right now we still say 附子 have big toxin like. We must be use prepared foods. We are not use raw foods. Raw foods even more toxic. I heard a story, TCM students in China, like the teacher tell them, raw foods is more toxic. But working stronger, and one students, they try to taste it about food. They eat small pieces of raw food. But after they feel pretty burning sensation in the mouth and in the stomach area for a few days. So that's truly pretty stronger. Pretty stronger herbs. So right now, basically, clinically, we are not using raw foods anymore. Even in here, I believe you couldn't find raw food. All the food you order is being cooked. That's what they call 熟附子. Like a cook. Or 黑附子. Hei is black color. Black color kind of food, still cooked. So we know food is a big toxin and warming herb. kind of wonderful. So in Shen Nong Ben Chao Jing, talking about they treat a lot of conditions. Mean the cold condition, they treat in Fuzi. I believe in ancient time, the weather is more cold compared right now. So that's truly Fuzi is pretty warming curve. So even right now, we are not directly used to treat wind cold condition. But if that wind cold go to more deeply and cause the long cold condition emitting like a flame, you still can think about it. But truly, right now, mainly we use Ganjiang instead because Fuzi, it is toxic herb, and Ganjiang is more safety used herb. But truly, Fuzi can treat that condition. Cause qi go to wrong direction, reverse qi, that's passenger qi, that's can, like ancient time, they use it. And the warming needle gel. Still like we talking about Simitang. That's the internal cold condition. So Fuzi. Fuzi, Ganjiang, they usually using together. There's an idea. There's an idea. Fuzi, if without Ganjiang, they will not warm, not that hot. So basically, right now, when we use Fuzi, we try to like tonify Yang and warming internally. So that's most formula. If they have Fuzi there, they will have Ganjiang because Ganjiang help with Fuzi getting warm. Like we talking about the herbs relationship before. One kind of relationship, they help each other. So Fuzi Ganjiang is like the pair herb. They can help each other. And the broken hardness here, that's thinking about basically still similar like a zheng jia condition, like a blood stasis condition, or qi stagnation kind of condition. So that kind of conditions mostly caused by cold. And the Fuzi have the warming nature. So that can relieve stagnation condition, including blood stasis kind of condition. And certainly can relieve cold dampness condition. Cold dampness can cause the B syndrome. We call cold mainly, we call tong. Dampness mainly, we call shi bi. Either of them will cause the pain in the joints. And the people have pain in the joints. They are pretty difficult to walk. So that's Fuzi warming treat this kind of a painful situation. And they grow in the mountain and what? So basically Fuzi grows in pretty high mountain. Yeah, pretty high mountain. Generally say the high mountain area, the temperature is pretty low. So that kind of natural itself must be very, very warm. Otherwise, they couldn't live in that kind of environment. So that's why Fuzi is originally they say it's warming, but truly it's pretty hot. So that's the Fuzi. Fuzi right now is still using. But be careful, they have toxins. They can cause very severe kind of reactions, like a nausea, vomiting, or even cause the irregular heartbeat. Even we use prepared food, but when we put the food to the decoction, we still cooking food first about 20 to 30 minutes. Then adding other herbs in. So in this way, we're reducing the toxin. Common use the dose for Fuzi around 10 to 15 grams. That's generally clinical we use. And we say cooking Fuzi early, 20 to 30 minutes, then adding other herbs. But truly right now in China, they have some TCM practitioners, they call Yang School. So they have the idea, like people life depending Yang. So all the problems caused by Yang deficiency. So in that kind of situation, they truly increase the dose for Fuzi. Sometimes they even use over 100 grams. I heard about good result from people use big dose of Fuzi. And I also heard about story, like some people got a pretty severe kind of side infection from high dose of Fuzi. So that's in China, different practitioners or doctors, they may have different ideas and they may have their special kind of treatment. Just let you know, you heard some people they talking about they use Fuzi pretty big dosage. Yeah, don't surprise. Yeah.
Sorry, Jin, what kind of infection did you say when they use too much of the Fuzi?
They just thinking about the like some severe kind of condition that must be young severe kind of deficiency. So then they use bigger dose of Fuzi, try to like stronger tonify Yang, make Yang more stronger. Yeah, it's a group of the people, yeah, group of TCM doctor or practitioner, they specially have their idea. They thinking about all the people like living, depending their Yang. All the problems is caused by Yang disease. So they use food, pretty big dose, yeah, pretty big dose. But for us, for safety, I still suggest you only use or common use dose, yeah. Just in case. Safety first, yeah, safety first. But truly later on, maybe you can hear some story about the food dolls, pretty big. Yeah. So that's the first herb we're talking about, the fuzi. Then we're talking about herb, 半夏. Banxia still belong to pungent herb. Not too cold, not too warm. Last we're talking about balance. Banxia still toxin herb. Banxia still toxin herb. So thus we still use prepared banxia right now. We are now truly use raw banxia. Prepared banxia, we may use some other herb to prepare it. One we call jiang banxia. Jiang banxia is prepared by shengjiang. One we call fa banxia. Fa banxia is prepared by Ming Fan. Ming Fan or category, external use the herb. But Ming Fan, like in ancient time, even right now, sometimes small dogs still can go to the food to pee. It's not that too toxin kind of herb. So that's sometimes we use Mingfan prepared banxia. So still talking about our herbs and the herbs. The relationship before we talking about like this page. Yeah, some herbs with single use and some herbs they needing each other. So that means they helping each other. And some herbs, they vary. That we use for some toxin herbs, like we talking about some toxin herbs. If we use, we can use like oxide and reducing their toxins. Yeah, if the herb have toxins, you can use them together, and they against each other can reduce the toxin. So that's basically when we're talking about banxia, they prepared way. Shengjiang reducing the toxin of banxia, and also Mingfan reducing the toxin of banxia. So that's we're talking about banxia right now. Must be used prepared. Otherwise, they are toxic. And it treat condition because it natural. So they can treat cold condition and heat condition. And also treat hardness below the heart. So that's basically we're talking about some stagnation in there. In ancient time, we're talking about below the heart, we're talking about the stomach area, middle jaw area. So that's basically we can treat some stagnations in the middle jaw. And also treat swells up, yeah, swollen and swells up. So that condition is not like we got a common cold caused the swells up. It's kind of more severe kind of like a swollen swells up. Then we can think about use 半夏补. And then some dizziness, chest distension, cough, even some phlegm coming out. So that's basically talking about some phlegm condition. That's pretty similar right now. We use 半夏, yeah. So right now we use 半夏, mainly result phlegm. So phlegm conditions and rushing up, go to the head, cause the dizziness. Go to the chest, cause chest distension, feeling. And go to the lung, cause the cough. And go to intestine, yeah, go to intestine. So sometimes we can hear the sounds coming from intestine. And stop sweating. He didn't specially say why it stopped sweating. But it's pretty possible, yeah, pretty possible we talk about relieve some water disorder. Like a dam is phlegm, then stop sweating. Yeah. And the growth in the river and the valley. So that's the location, like tell the doctors where you can find the banxia. So we say in ancient time, the doctors need to pick up the herb themselves. So in the book, yeah, herbs book, they tell the people where you can find it. So that's 半夏, yeah, that's 半夏. So some people explanations for stop sweating. So say 半夏 is pungent herb, but also have kind of astringent nature inside. So we know astringent herb can stop sweating. So that's some doctors do some explanations for why 半夏 can stop the sweating. So that's 半夏. Then we go to another herb in this category, 大黄. 大黄 still pretty commonly used herbs, like in 大承气汤, 小承气汤, 调味承气汤. So we can use 大黄. 大黄 is a bit bitter, cold, and toxic. So right now we didn't think about 大黄 to toxins, but originally they talking about they have some toxin. Truly, 大黄 is a purging herb. We couldn't use overdose. If we use overdose, cause the patient like couldn't stop for a moment. And the 大黄 also can move in blood. Relieve blood stasis kind of condition. So generally speaking, 大黄, if you're cooking short time, they will purging down. Yeah, they will purging down. like some people have heat inside, especially in Yangming, caused constipation. You cooking the da huang short time, like you cooking other herbs first, then adding da huang. But if you cooking da huang longer time, basically da huang will moving blood, result blood phases. So even da huang not in the herb category, like a stop blood stasis category, but truly da huang have its function. So that means clinically, when you use da huang, like when you use the raw herb, you need to think about what kind of functions you like to use. If you like to use da huang to purging down, adding it later. But if you try to use da huang, moving blood stasis, you better cooking longer time and reducing, in that kind of case, purging down function is a side effect. So that's depending your cooking way, da huang have their self function. So they can treat the conditions, maybe cold, maybe heat, but mainly it's caused the stasis inside. And also for food retention. That's we can directly put it down. That's directly put it down. And remove still zhengjia conditions, blood stasis, qi stagnations. And when they moving everything down, like empty stomach and intestine, and ready for some new food coming in. So da huang, regular needle jiao and transforming food and harmonize for five zang organs. So that's basically we're talking about some stagnation condition, blocking in the middle jiao, in the stomach, in the intestine. Then they were purging down. Then they recover the function and they harmonize five zang organs. So da huang still grows in the mountain and the valley. So last herbs in this category, we pick up jiegeng. Jiegeng in infer category, but it is no toxin. It's not means it is toxin. We say infer category we use for zuo shi herb. What means zuo shi? Zuo shi means they can lend in the herbs, go to special locations. So we know jiegeng specially is good lending the herb, go to the lung. So you can see a lot of formulas, they have jiegeng there. And they also can go to middle jiao and lower jiao, like a community with three jiao there. So that's in Shennong Ben Cao Jing, they say, mainly treat chest, rib, side pain. It look like a pretty severe kind of pain. They're talking about look like a knife go to the rib cage and the side eye. So that's we're talking about sharpen. Yeah, sharpen is kind of blood stasis. But truly, jiegang itself is not like working like moving blood there. It is just lending other herbs go to upper jaw. And also abdominal phoning. Still not directly like a jiegang working for that. They still lending other herbs go to middle jaw. And the intestine, some painful situation or uncomfortable situation. So that's me, jiegang, go to three jiaos. And also some people have palpitations, kind of conditions. We also can use jiegang. Palpitation is typically symptoms of the heart. Heart belongs to upper jaw. So they're still working for heart condition. So generally speaking, jiegang putting in the infer category just because we use it as duoshi herb. They can lend in other herbs, go to upper jaw, middle jaw, and lower jaw, and treat three jaw problems here. So that's jiegang. It's very, very common use herb. So you can find jiegang in lot of formulas. Certainly, it mainly go to the lung, but it truly treat some other conditions. And the growth in the mountain and the valley. So that's the most herb we can find in the mountain and valley. So that's our info herb, which is pick up four. Yeah.